Let us now try to find numerical solution for the Colebrook-white formula. First we will look at the theory and then we will use the solution that we iterative solution that we arrive at. We will use that equation in octave and then execute that and try to find the friction factor. So we know the Colebrook-white equation. It is like this. You are now familiar with this. Now 1 by root of f. Let us replace it with one symbol. Epsilon by D, roughness ratio by 3.7, we will replace it with one more symbol. 2.51 by Reynolds number, we will replace it with one symbol. For a given Reynolds number and given roughness index, this portion and this 2.51 by Reynolds number will be a constant. So let us say x is equal to 1 by root of f. We will use that symbol for 1 by root of f, and then we will use the symbol a for epsilon by d by 3.7, and we will use the symbol b for 2.51 by Reynolds number. So now this Colebrook-white formula becomes simple to read. X is equal to minus 2 log to base 10 a plus b x. So this is the equation for which we need to find the root and find the value of x. Now let us say g of x is equal to x plus this one. We will take x plus this onto the left hand side, which will make it 0. So that is the function g of x, x plus 2 log base 10 a plus b x. And we know that this should become 0, and that is why we put it as equal to 0. So we'll try to solve this gx equation iteratively and find a value of x such that gx is 0. So that is what we want to do, and for that there are ready methods and techniques. We will use the Newton-Cotes techniques for solving this iterative relationship. So now consider this equation gx is equal to x plus 2 log base 10 a plus bx equal to 0. Del g by del x, partial derivative of g with respect to x, will give you g prime, which is equal to 1 plus 2b by a plus bx. Now gx evaluated at k will be gxk is equal to delta change in x and multiplied by the slope del g by del x. So this is evaluated at x is equal to xk. So this is the Newton-Cotes rule. This will give you an evaluation of g at xk. Now delta x is nothing but xk minus xk plus 1. So previous iteration minus the next present iteration minus the next iteration value. So this into g prime evaluated at xk. So now this equation, if you rearrange them, you will get xk plus 1 is equal to xk minus g evaluated at xk by g prime evaluated at xk. So this would become our iterative equation in a more generic sense. Now we will replace this equation for g and g prime here. So xk plus 1 is equal to xk minus g is nothing but this part of the equation, xk plus 2 log base 10 a plus b xk evaluated at xk, divided by that portion divided by g prime, which is this portion with x evaluated at xk, 1 plus 2b by a plus b xk. So this is the entire iterative equation. Let us do some simplification. On simplifying, we get xk plus 1 is equal to 2bxk minus 2 a plus bxk log to base 10 a plus bxk whole divided by a plus bxk plus 2b. So this is the entire simplified iterative equation that we would like to numerically compute. Now what should be the starting value of xk initial? So that I will take it as 1 by root of f, and that f is 1 by root of 0.1. f is nothing but 0.1 what I have taken. How do we arrive at this value? If you look at the Moody chart, this x-axis is nothing but friction factor. So I have taken a high value of friction factor 0.1 here. So from here it should come down and boil down to the proper value of friction factor for different Reynolds numbers. So it should converge there. So this initial value guess is from the Moody chart, and you can use this value of 1 by root of 0.1 for any value of Reynolds number and roughness ratio. Generally from that value it will converge to the final resulting value, which is desirable, for which value the gx or gxk will become 0. Let us now implement this iterative equation in octave and obtain the value of x, and then from x the value of friction factor, because friction factor and x are related by x is equal to 1 by root f and f is equal to 1 by x square. After we have finished the iteration, we would have found out xk plus 1, for which gxk plus 1 is almost equal to 0. And using that value of xk plus 1, 1 by xk plus 1 square will give friction factor. So that will be the final value of friction factor, which we will use it for plugging into the Darcy-Weisbach formula to obtain the friction loss head.